Wavy News team are standing by now with Wavy News 10 at 6.
Now, from the station on your side, this is Wavy News 10.
Four big stories at 6 o'clock. A bail bondsman locked up himself after some serious accusations involving a woman he bailed out. A huge fire at a motel. People in the rooms having to run for their lives. A deadly crash leads to hours of gridlock and commuter chaos. And we need it, and we'll get a lot of rain, which is headed our way. We're going to start at 6 o'clock with that bail bondsman accused of raping a woman who called him to get her out of jail. A 10 on Your Side viewer sent us this video of John Stifler being hauled in by police. As with every story, there's at least two sides. And only on 10, the bondsman himself has something to say about this from jail. 10 on Your Side's Jason Marks has a developing story from Norfolk. Jason.
Tom, we just finished up that interview with John Stifler. He tells us he believes these allegations were made out of revenge. John Stifler makes his living getting people out of jail, but now he finds himself behind bars.
I never in a million years expected this to happen.
Stifler was arrested last night. This is video from a 10 on Your Side viewer as police put him in handcuffs.
It's devastating because I would never do anything of that nature.
The 37-year-old owner of AAA Bail Bonds is accused of raping one of his clients. He says he bonded her out of jail a couple months ago. She then called him in June from Bedford County the day before her court date in Virginia Beach and said she needed a ride back.
I did bring her back to Norfolk. And when we got back to Norfolk, I actually took her to the IHOP restaurant, bought her something to eat that night, and then let her sleep on my couch.
He says he did that because he didn't want to lose sight of her for fear that if she missed court, he'd be out $5,000. Though that morning, he was forced to revoke her bond. But the woman, though, tells police a different story about the events that happened at his Norfolk home.
She's saying that I forcefully brought her back from Bedford County, took her to my residence where I handcuffed her to the bed all night, and raped her repeatedly.
The woman didn't file a police report until a month after the alleged incident.
Just this one allegation, she's upset because I put her back, because I had to revoke her bond. I mean, I don't know what else to do.
He now waits for his bond hearing and for somebody to get him out. He says even if he's found innocent, this will leave a mark.
I'm not a rapist. I have not raped anybody.
And Stifler looked at me right in the eyes and he says when he's found innocent, he does not believe he'll be able to go back and do something he loves to do, and that's being a bondsman. He will make his first court appearance tomorrow morning. We're live in Norfolk. Jason Marks, 10 on Your Side.
Also tonight, rain on the way, much needed for a lot of us, but the rain we could get out of this next system might just be too much. I'm here with the chief meteorologist Don Slater to prepare for the storm.
For the storm. We've got plenty of time to prepare for the storm. But if you've got gutters that are full, if you've got stuff that's outside, you need to bring in.
How about if you have no gutters?
Rain will fall right off. Anyway, here's a look at what's going on the wide view of things, because this St. Louis storm, way on off toward the Mississippi Valley, is likely to move eastward, cross our area, and move across our area by late Friday. And it is going to bring a more significant rainfall to the region. I want to show you a wide view of our future track computer model, show you where it's coming from, and show you where we're going to get the rainfall out of this. You can see this thing spinning. There's where it is by tomorrow evening. It's right on into here toward Tennessee. Now we move on eastward, and then finally, by Friday, late in the day, it's right on in over the top of our area, and likely to move right on through with a good slug of rainfall. Here's the rainfall for the eastern half of the United States over the next couple of days, all the way to Friday evening at 7. So yeah, pretty good slug of some rainfall into the region, and it's likely to happen, most of it likely to happen from late tomorrow and on into the day on Friday. Most of the rain holds off until late tomorrow, and then off and on rain throughout the day on Friday. Some of it could be heavy. I'll show you when and where and how much we're going to get out of this. That'll be coming up with our forecast for you in just a few minutes.
And track the rain for yourself on your smartphone or tablet with the Wavy Weather app. Our radar includes lightning data and watches and warnings if we get any, a great tool to have. Now, if you were in East Ocean View or within a couple of miles of that part of Norfolk, you could not miss this. a huge plume of smoke coming from a fast-moving motel fire on Shore Drive. And the video from Chopper 10, wow, it shows an end result here. The M-Star is destroyed. And a lot of people who were staying and living there have nowhere else to go. Then at your side's Brandi Cummings has been there all day long. Brandi.
Tom, you know, this is still a very active scene here. Taking a look behind me, you can see several Norfolk police officers standing guard there, blocking the street. And up ahead, just over them, you can still see firefighters putting water on the M-Star Hotel. Just moments ago, we saw more smoke coming from the hotel. I spoke to a fire official who told me it didn't rekindle. They're just moving things around, making sure they have put out all the hot spots. It's been more than 9 hours. The fire marshal is still working to try to figure out how this started. Meanwhile, people who were inside of the hotel are just looking for another place to live.
I saw a lot of black smoke coming out the ceiling, off the roof. And
it could be seen for miles.
I heard a knock on the door. A guy screamed it was a fire.
Thick black smoke filled the air. People at the M-Star Hotel forced out.
That's the first thing I noticed was a plastic smell, like burning plastic. I thought it was, you know, something electrical because the outlets were out. But once I saw the smoke coming in through the bathroom, I knew it was time to get out.
Outside, dozens watched firefighters put out the flames.
Pretty involved when units arrived. They had smoke showing from the second floor up in the attic spaces.
But this was more than they expected. Even the firefighters had to pull back.
By the fire being so advanced and moving so fast, we had to withdraw our firefighters from the interior and get them on the outside of the building in a safe area so they can attack this fire.
The heat making things more difficult.
It gets pretty hot for us with all the gear on. It's probably approximately 50 pounds of gear that they have on them working right now.
67 of the 105 rooms here were occupied. Many of those people who've been living here lost everything.
We don't have nowhere to go.
We lost a lot of stuff, a lot of belongings right now, so it's hurting right now.
And back here now live, you can still see firefighters again here at the hotel trying to make sure all of the hot spots are out. The Red Cross is here helping all of the folks that were displaced. But so far, Tom, there is no word again on what started this fire, but thankfully no one was hurt. For now, live in Norfolk, I'm Brandi Cummings, 10 on your side.
Certainly that is the bottom line. And a lot of you were witness to this huge fire and sent pictures to report it at wavy.com. You can check them out right now. They are attached to this link here on our website. Traffic on the Western Freeway is moving smoothly again after a deadly accident shut down the road for hours. Two tractor trailers collided on the eastbound lane of the West Norfolk Bridge, right near the Midtown Tunnel. Portsmouth police say the driver of the white truck lost control, hit a Jersey wall, and then hit a second truck. The 59-year-old driver was ejected from his vehicle and later died. At some point, his trailer detached from the cab. It overturned, and boxes of sardines were spread all over the road. Took a long time to clean up. Now, here's the view from Chopper 10. Nearly 7 hours after the crash happened, the eastbound lanes of the bridge finally reopened before 4 o'clock. The bridge itself was not damaged, but a light pole that it had hit, was hit, tumbled into the water, and an overhead sign that was damaged had to be removed. In Hampton, two teenagers are charged with murder after beating a homeless man. Officers found the body of 53-year-old Charles Amos last night behind the Buckrow Beach Market on Buckrow Avenue. The discovery was made at about 10:30 last night. Police say Amos and another homeless man were attacked and robbed by those teens. The suspects are locked up, and they face a list of charges. In Newport News, police are looking for whoever shot a security guard. Investigators say the guard heard something near the stairwell of the building on Waterfront Circle around 3 a.m., and we went to check it out. He struggled with a man and the gun went off. The guard was shot in the foot as a result, but we're told he should recover. Still to come on Wavy News 10 at 6. Months later and hundreds of miles away, a man accused of killing a mother in New England is caught in Hampton Roads. Plus, a vigilant neighbor puts the brakes on some young burglars. See how one phone call can make a difference in fighting crime. And in sports, Bruce Rader has a look at the future of the Redskins, the rookie roster. And Don is back to track all of that rain headed our way. Then on NBC Nightly News with Lester Holt, the latest on a man shot by police inside a movie theater in Tennessee. What we know coming up at 6:30 right after Wavy News 10 at 6.
You're watching Wavy News 10 at 6 with Tom Shadd.
Nicole Livas, Chief Meteorologist Don Slater, and Bruce Rader Sports. Before a storm hits, pick up the Super Doppler 10 Hurricane Ready Guide at your local Farm Fresh supermarket. It's filled with vital information to help you protect your family and your home. Sponsored by Farm Fresh and air conditioning specialists.
We're in your community.
On your street.
Asking hard questions.
To get you honest answers.
Watch Wavy News 10 weeknights at 10 on Fox 43.
You want the latest trend, but care how much you spend. It will be your loss if you don't go to Ross.
This outfit is $103 at department stores, but at Ross, it's less than $55.
Gotta go to Ross, gotta go to Ross.
Your kitchen is the heart of your home, so let's show it some love. Hatchet Design Remodel will customize a kitchen for your family to enjoy every day and for your friends to envy when you entertain. From the wow-worthy features to every functional detail, we know you'll love your new kitchen by Hatchet Design Remodel. So call now and save up to $2,500 off a full kitchen remodel by Hatchet.
Call Hatchet Design Remodel today for your free consultation. It costs nothing to ask.
Remember how excited you were when your mom made breakfast for dinner? It felt like you were breaking the rules. But whoever made the rule that breakfast has to end at 10 a.m.? At Bojangles, we believe that breakfast isn't a time. It's a state of mind. That's why we serve our made-from-scratch biscuits hot and fresh all day, every day. Besides, who are we to say when breakfast should end? At Bojangles, it's all about the biscuits. Get two sausage and egg biscuits for just $3.50. Bojangles, it's bow time.
Jeffy1016 posted,
"Worked hard, promotion, time to play hard. Hashtag upgrade my car."
Congrats, Jeffy. Now's the time to hit the Honda Summer Clearance Event. You can get a great deal on the Honda Accord from KBB.com's best overall brand. With rearview camera and text message reader standard, it's the perfect upgrade.
Awesome.
Go, Jeffy. Go, Jeffy.
Hurry in to the Honda Summer Clearance Event for a great deal on your new Honda.
Kids grow up fast, and no matter what size they are, Ross has a huge selection of the top brands to fit them and your budget. Like this outfit, $65.99 at department stores, but if you want it for less than half, you gotta go to Ross.
If you can, we can. Michael and Son.
These pictures show the aftermath of a frightening wake-up call in Hampton this morning. At 10 on your side has the video from a duplex on Homestead Avenue, a fire here. One of the residents called 911 to say he was trapped inside his burning home. Firefighters pulled two people through a window to safety. In all, nine people were left homeless, including five children. The cause? That's not been determined yet. A registered sex offender with ties to Hampton Roads now faces murder charges in Massachusetts. This is 37-year-old Jason Fleury. Police arrested him yesterday in Hampton, but he has addresses listed in Newport News and Gloucester. They say he murdered 25-year-old Jamie Mendez. She was last seen back in November 2014. In January, her remains washed ashore on a Massachusetts beach. The Mendez family told our Boston affiliate they found evidence in a dumpster that catapulted the police investigation, shoes belonging to Mendez and a piece of carpet allegedly from inside Fleury's van.
She just had a hunch. She was driving around trying to find this house. She drove by the dumpster and just had a hunch to look in, and she's the one that actually found the shoes. She noticed the rug, and at that point she called the police and they took it over.
Tomorrow, Fleury will be arraigned in Massachusetts on that murder charge. Next at 6, neighbors helping neighbors, and in this case, a neighbor's call to 911 may have stopped two burglars from doing any more damage. Plus, Don's wet forecast. And remember, you can always get the latest weather anytime on wavy.com. Much more when we come back.
Shane is a student at ECPI University.
But for 9 years, he worked late nights, which took an emotional and physical toll. He was ready for a change, and ECPI offered him the opportunity to explore new career choices. Shane will graduate with a degree in cloud computing and is already working, providing businesses more efficient data management over the internet.
ECPI was the best decision I ever made.
Discover cloud computing at ECPI University, on campus or online. Go to ecpi.edu today.
Harrison's has been helping families move since 1956, yet some folks still haven't heard of us. Maybe our commercials aren't aggressive enough.
I'm Stan the Moving Man telling you to call Harrison's right now. Anywhere you go, we save you dough. We wrap, pack, stack, and do all that. We train so you won't complain.
True, Stan, but that's not how we roll. Boys.
Call 399-MOVE! 399-MOVE!
That's 399-MOVE, in case somehow you missed.
Right now, Griffin Doors will deliver and install a belt-driven garage door opener for $299.
Protect your home from termites. Contact Home Paramount Pest Control today for a free inspection. Call 888-888-HOME or visit homeparamount.com.
When something isn't right,
somebody's supposed to be watching out for him. He can get hurt.
10 on Your Side gets to work.
I want them to do something about it. I don't want this to happen to anybody else.
Turning up the heat to get you answers.
You need to leave the property and you cannot be here.
A voice for those who need it most.
Why did you contact 10 on Your Side?
I was hoping to get some attention to get this issue resolved.
Wavy News 10, always on your side.
This segment of Wavy News 10 is brought to you by Priority Automotive, where you can have it all.
10 on Your Side wants every child to start off the school year right.
And you can help make that happen with Operation School Supplies.
Drop off your school supplies at any Farm Fresh supermarket.
Every child deserves to go to the head of the class.
With Operation School Supplies.
Your community. Your music. Your events. Your scene. HRScene.com. The best place to keep you connected to everything happening in Hampton Roads.
From the station on your side, you're watching Wavy News 10 at 6.
Well, sometimes you just have to take matters into your own hands, especially when it comes to stopping quality of life crimes. That's why two people are under arrest after a series of car break-ins overnight on Sheringham East, just north of Hilltop. One call to 911 stopped the situation from getting worse. Then on your side's Matt Gregory is here with the story for us. Matt?
Tom, a group of tight-knit homeowners live on a little cul-de-sac in Virginia Beach. Neighbors say they look out for each other. Well, early this morning, one of them looked out for all of them.
We got the call from the citizen at about 3 o'clock this morning saying that there's two individuals going through, basically checking doors, going into vehicles.
The two thieves grabbed whatever they could steal from the cars on Sheringham East. Unknown to them, these homeowners keep a watchful eye.
Cheshire is filled with people who are mostly original homeowners here, and we do look out for each other, and we're always looking out the windows.
Early Wednesday morning, while the suspects went to work, a neighbor watched them from their window while talking to police.
The caller basically stayed on the phone with the dispatcher who was giving us the details of, well, they're at this car, now they're at my neighbor's car, they're at this car, they tried my car.
When police arrived, they had a description of the suspects and even caught one in the act on the cul-de-sac. Police chased them to a nearby school.
A couple of the officers actually went into the wooded area and was able to chase them and corner them, pushing them into the other officers.
Police arrested both juveniles and say they recovered most of the stolen goods. And back on the cul-de-sac, neighbors like Jamay Ravel say the neighborhood has returned to its quiet ways, thanks to neighbors who keep an eye on each other.
Oh, I think they should get an award. Bless their hearts. I think that was wonderful that it even, you know, under the circumstances, they were able to see it.
Virginia Beach police say they turned over the juveniles to their parents and they'll have a court date coming up. Matt Gregory, 10 on Your Side.
The no swimming signs are back up again at two beaches in Newport News. The advisories are for Hilton Beach and Huntington Park Beach. Water samples showed that bacteria levels there could make you sick. The beach is okay. The water, not so much. We'll let you know when those advisories are taken down.
Now, your Super Doppler 10 forecast with Chief Meteorologist Don Slater.
And as he puts his coat on, gets ready to do things here, we're looking at clear skies throughout the area. Really, really very, very pleasant weather throughout the entire region. I'm just updating everything here for you. I want to show you what's going on, where this rainfall is going to be coming from. And it's coming from St. Louis. If you were watching earlier, I showed you how that thing is going to move halfway across the United States. Go get us. And it is going to bring rainfall, mainly late tomorrow and on into Friday. We could see a stray shower overnight, certainly during the first part of the day tomorrow, but by later on in the afternoon tomorrow into tomorrow night, a really good slug of rainfall moving on in. 9 o'clock this evening, all is quiet. Light southeasterly wind at 10 miles an hour. Now, what we ended up with was a cool front dropping on through overnight. Where was the cooler air? Well, it wasn't all that much cooler. Maybe a degree or two cooler. A little bit drier air for the day today. Well, that front is stuck. It's become stationary, and there'll be little ripples along that front, which could bring us a little bit of rainfall overnight. Not all that much. Could bring us a little bit of rainfall coming up tomorrow morning. That low is basically right on into here tomorrow morning at 7 o'clock, and behind it, you can see these scattered showers moving on through. There's where we are at the noon hour. Not all that much rain. Not all that much rainfall at 3 o'clock, but by the end of the afternoon, good chance of rainfall into the area. Showers and thunderstorms, and some of these could contain some heavier rainfall during the latter part of the day tomorrow. Now, tomorrow night, yeah, more rainfall, especially in the northern portions of our area by midnight. Settles down a little bit overnight, but then it'll perk back up again during the day coming up on Friday. This is our Friday morning at 7. That low-pressure area, which is now in St. Louis, is going to be making its way across our area, certainly by the noon hour on Friday. Scattered showers, some rumbles of thunder, southwest winds 10 to 20 here. And on the back side of that low, it circulates counterclockwise. We see more of a northeasterly wind. We're all going to end up with that coming up by the end of the day Friday. This is our Friday at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And by Friday evening, a north-northeasterly wind at 15 to 20. We could even see tides rise up a little bit at the end of the day on Friday and into Saturday. We could see some nuisance tidal flooding because of that persistent northeasterly wind flows that makes its way on out to sea. Total rainfall, two different versions of future track. They both pretty much agree. I think they've got areas that have too much. 5 3/4, 6 1/4 inches of rain. I'm tending to think around 2 3 inches of rain for most of us. That's a lot. That's a lot of rain. This thing goes through the roof as far as some rainfall, 10 inches. But still, I think we're going to see, again, around 2 3 inches of rainfall into the area coming up between Thursday and Friday. Right now, 88, 90, 92, 93 degrees into the region. We take a look at what's going on with temperatures throughout the region. At 98 is too much. It's mostly into the 80s to around the 90 degree mark into the Hampton Roads city. So again, it's a good warm day, slightly less humidity into the area, and we'll see a lot more humidity obviously coming up for tomorrow with a good chance of rain by the afternoon and evening hours. And that rain will continue off and on into Friday, and some coastal showers coming up during the day on Saturday, but much cooler weather coming up by the weekend. Well, join us for an update on all the forecast models coming up at 11.
I mentioned last week, Redskins coach John Gruden is calling this year's training camp the Show Me Camp. Show me you can play. And tonight, we're going to check in with the rookies on our Redskins training camp report from Richmond, next on the Sports Wrap.
Cole Decker, if you're hurt, like in an accident, their advice won't cost you anything.
We've been helping people just like you for 50 years. Make the right call now.
Cole Decker. Helping people.
Never clean out your gutters again. Leaf Guard by Starling Guttering. Wavy's expert on your side.
Buyers use the Toyota badge as a shorthand for high quality and strong resale value. Because Toyotas help keep ownership costs lower. Which is why all these Toyotas are ranked an excellent value by IntelliChoice.com. So choose your car wisely and think Toyota. Just ask a friend who drives one. Toyota, let's go places.
For 3 days only, it's the Sales Tax Holiday Event at Ashley Furniture Home Store in Chesapeake and Virginia Beach. Get a discount equal to your sales tax, 10% savings, free financing, and free delivery. Now at Ashley Home Store.
Farm Fresh cares about the future of Hampton Roads and the children that will later lead the way. Help them start the school year off with the supplies they need to be successful. Farm Fresh, freshness you deserve, savings you expect.
Wherever you're headed in the morning, I can help you get there.
Start your day with 10 Time Saver Traffic. Your commute begins here on Wavy News 10 Today. 10 on Your Side, investigating for you.
We just want to know why you haven't paid people back.
Revealing more tunnel toll billing problems.
How does someone get 9 bills in 1 month?
Uncovering controversy at City Hall.
Without 10 on Your Side looking into this, nobody would have known.
Exposing a failing system.
The main concern is the children are not safe.
And only Andy Fox went diving with sharks to separate fact from fiction. That's 10 on Your Side.
Hey Tides fans, join me Friday, August 21st at Harbor Park as the Tides take on the Columbus Clippers. Get there early. The first 5,000 fans get a Tides baseball cap. It's Wavy TV 10 Tides Night. See you at the game.
Weather affects you every day. So get an easy-to-understand forecast for where you live. Rely on the Super Doppler 10 weather team, always on your side.
Day six of Redskins coach Jay Gruden's second training camp. Another scorching day up in Richmond. The veterans tolerate it. The rookies would be sweating regardless of the temperatures. With 90 players on the roster, 37 of them will be cut prior to the season opener against the Dolphins. I'm Bruce Rader, and when your football team goes 7-25 over the past 2 years, few jobs are secure. That's the fact for those guys hoping to make the Skins' final roster. New general manager Scott McLuhan wants his team bigger, faster, and younger. And Nathan Epstein checks out the young guns tonight in our Redskins training camp report.
The Redskins' top two picks are expected to see significant playing time. Second-round defensive end Preston Smith and the team's top pick, guard Brandon Scherff.
You can't really think about that. You know, each place is, each spot is earned, so that's what you got to do. Come out each and every day and try to earn your spot.
At 6'5", 320 pounds, Scherff is going to add more bulk to a rushing attack that ranked 19th in the NFL last season. Right now, he says, it's just an adjustment period.
I think it's going well. You know, I'm just trying to mesh in with the older guys and, you know, trying to learn from them. I got a lot of great guys that are helping me, you know, move along, so I'm just trying to, you know, take each day and improve on something I didn't do yesterday and, you know, just try to learn from the older guys.
Somebody he could be blocking for, Matt Jones, the team's third-round running back out of Florida, who could be a nice complement to Alfred Morris.
I'm loving everything they're doing about it. You know, it's a downhill offense, passing the ball as well. It's just great to be out here with all the guys, learning a new offense.
At 6'3", 230 pounds, size is not his biggest issue.
It's a whole lot different from, you know, high schools to college and college to the pros, so you just got to get used to that speed.
Maybe the most intriguing prospect, Jamison Crowder, receiver taken in the fourth round out of Duke, who's looked very solid to this point.
You know, he's very smart, went to Duke and, you know, understands the passing game, understands route concepts, and got good, strong hands, very quick in and out of breaks.
I'm just trying to learn and pick up as much as I can, you know, be able to get on the field somehow, some way, whether it's at receiver or at special team.
Gruden says there's definitely a place for him as a punt returner, but could he move past Andre Roberts for the third receiver spot?
We'll see. We got a long time to determine who our third is. Right now, Andre obviously has a firm grasp on it, but he will challenge him.
All the rookies will see their first game action on August 13th at Redskins training camp. Nathan Epstein for the Sports Wrap.
Thank you, Nathan. The Redskins made their first big cut of training camp today, waiving safety Philip Thomas. Tomorrow, the Houston Texans come to Richmond for 3 days. We'll have live coverage tomorrow night here on Wavy News 10 at 6. The first place Norfolk Tides are at home tonight at Harbor Park is Virginia Tech Hokies night. I'll have that story and the rest of the sports of the day tonight at 10:45 on the Fox 43 Sports Wrap, and I'll see you guys back here at 11.
And to paraphrase Don Slater's favorite animated meteorologist, it's going to rain.
It's going to rain, Ollie. Here's a look. Yeah, it really is going to rain. We're going to see 2-3 inches of rain by the time it's all said and done on Friday evening. You'll want to join us at 11. I'll have the latest forecast models for you.
I'll see you then.